What's up, guys? Crazy VR here. Today I'm bringing you guys Quantum Break episode number 12, I believe. And yes, the video is frozen for a second. The game's just loading. There you go. This is getting really, really intense, and I'm really excited for it. I've actually recorded, I guess this is the sixth episode I've recorded in the last 2 days. I didn't think I would get this into this game, and then now I just can't stop playing it because I want to finish it. Second of all, I'm getting really excited because it's really, really fun. So it's getting really intense. People have been asking me, is it a good
shut up for a second. The entire world. I can't even keep up with the reports. Listeners, you really wanna stay indoors. The run side, we don't know.
Time was broken. Working out of sync. The city was in a state of chaos. The end of time was closing in.
And you still believed you could fix it?
The solution was inside Monarch Tower. The countermeasure.
The CFR, as Monarch knew it. The key to the lifeboat protocol. Monarch's survival plan. But that didn't seem to matter to you.
I had a better plan.
So people keep asking me, like, oh, should I get Quantum Break? And at first I was saying, no, not really. It's
okay,
not.
Okay,
damn. Oh,
Christ.
I was like, no, it's not really worth it. You shouldn't even get it. I wouldn't. Oh shit. I looked over to make sure I was still recording and died. Oh well. I was saying at first, no, it's not Christ. Worth it. And now I'm saying, like, yeah, like, just get past, all you gotta do is get past the first part. Oh shit, there's enemies. I may die. I'm gonna be bitching. So, I would definitely say that this game is good, and you should definitely get it if you're still not sure. Excuse me, Mr. Train Driver, can you stop shining your bright light in my eyes, please? There we go. Roll with. Damn. Hopefully just the second set of enemies. Nope.
Christ.
Okay. So yeah, to anybody still considering getting this game, if you're not sure, I would definitely recommend it. Where's an easy button when you need it? Cause... That guy just didn't want to die. How rude.
Where are they keeping the calendar? Shouldn't be too hard to find. It's the biggest dead building we've ever before.
Accurate.
So, who are you exactly? Why are you helping me?
Look, I'm not here to fuck you over, dude. We all want the same thing. Look, I'm gonna be honest. I don't know how you getting the CFR is gonna help, but at this point, I'll take a slim hope for no hope. Put your big boy pants on and get it done.
Go.
I was getting closer to the countermeasure. Paul had the key to fixing the fracture all along, but he didn't see it.
There was nothing to see. He believed the fracture couldn't be fixed. That's why he used the countermeasure, the CFR, to create the lifeboat.
Oh, shit.
Hey, guy. You in there? I'm locked out.
Yeah. I'm gonna get that door for you. Hang on. But be careful. There's a lot of scared and angry meatheads on the other side. There you go. Don't get your ass killed.
That was easy. So mad. Got one down. There we go.
The guy with the countermeasure. I need to access that sky bridge.
Yeah, no problem. Just a sec. Well, you better keep an eye out, Joyce. That thing out there, I don't think it's gone. Okay, off you go.
Monarch was scrambling. Paul's empire was falling apart all around me. I'd never seen anything like it. But Paul had. That's what he was preparing for all those years. He didn't do a very good job.
Yay, we get some shit to read. What the hell? Alright. Hey, Sophia. Still haven't heard from you about my screenplay. I know you're busy with all your work, but this is really taking off in a big way, so let's try to get going on this, okay? I know this thing is going to be huge, so I just went ahead and mortgaged my house to make this thing reality. It's my dream, and I'm going to follow my dream. And once I get the Kickstarter going, this thing's going to pay me back for the mortgage, so no problem. I already shot a short porno thing for the KS campaign. Let me know what you think. I'm going to star in it, but I've got a really cool part for you, too, if you want it. You'd be perfect for it. Also, like I said, I'm going to need that science feedback stuff soon. Let me know ASAP. Great, so now this dude's trying to get a doctor to do porn with him.
They have a time machine here? Shit. This is where they brought the university core.
And sure, personally, let's see if our chambers are secure.
Looks like they have it on the top floor.
Mr. Serene, I know you're not in the HQ right now, and whatever mission you left on must be incredibly urgent, so you probably won't read this until you return. I know that you will be very, very angry with me, but I have to tell you what I've done. Using my maintenance access, I've deactivated the stutter proofing at the building. I know you will be furious, but I did it because Martin Hatch threatened my family. I'm not going to lie, I'm scared to tell you this because I know you're on edge as it is, and clearly under tremendous pressure. But I have admired you and your vision for as long as I have worked for you, and I want to believe you can still fix the things. So you know, you have to know that it's Hatch. He made this happen. He knew exactly what would. I'm sorry, there are now dead people at my feet. I don't know how to effing deal with this. They're strikers. They weren't here when I started writing this email, and now they are. There's a lot of blood. I literally had to wipe it off the screen just to be able to keep typing. It had to be a shifter that killed them. Their Cronin harnesses are broken. I couldn't wear them if I wanted. But with that one, I'm safe, right? No shifters outside of stutters, or that's what they told us in training. So I'm safe. And when a stutter hits, I don't even notice unless a plane hits in the building or something. God, I have effed up so badly. People are dead because of me, not just these two, but throughout the building. The stutter proofing was supposed to keep the shifters out, and now everybody must be dying somewhere between the seconds. Everybody could be dead already. I don't know. I can't take this. And don't trust Hatch. I think that son of a bitch is after the CFR. I think he was never on our side. This is all some kind of weird game to him. Shit, I don't know why he's doing this. I'm just an engineer, and I don't know how to deal with this. It's too much, sir. Sir, I know you must be furious at me. I deserve it. Believe me, I know. but please don't take it out on my family. Goodbye, Bernard Riker, Senior Cronin Tech. Just making sure there's no more narrative stuff. That's just not a subject. Oh god, there's a loud ringing in my left ear.
What was that thing?
The train.
All personnel, stay clear of the lower levels. There's a possible hazard.
Hey, Charlie. I got another locked door here.
Not bad, Joyce. That's Serene's office. Let me just unlock that bad boy for you. Serene's got access to the CFR chamber from his office. I'll meet you there. Ah, there.
Paul was already gone, but he left behind the one thing I needed.
My office alarm went off. Is that you skulking around, Jack?
Fuck you. I'm done playing games. I'm here for what you stole.
Yes, of course.
The CFR. If you understood just how much depended on that, you'd leave it alone. But I know you don't care.
You're right. I don't. And it looks like you're not here to stop me.
Yes. Yes, everything will play out as it has to play out. I'll see you very soon, Jack.
Countermeasure was Paul's prize. Everything he built was based on Will's device. His plan depended on it. You better believe I look forward to taking it from him.
What happened to you? Looks like you ran into that creepy thing.
Seventeen years, he lived through twice. All of it mapped out, from memory.
He knew the market trends before they occurred. He had the tools to make a fortune, and he did.
Paul told me that he tried to change things. It failed. What he'd seen, it broke him. And I'd seen Beth go down the same path. Paul, it consumed him.
More emails. Alright, I think this is just a long one. I always scroll to the bottom to make sure it's not multiple ones. Paul, Martin, I know you've both been arguing that the Quantum Ripple Casualty Research Subdivision has great potential and we should keep it funded. I must once again employ you to reconsider. I'll be the first one to admit that the technology is impressive. The fact that Doctors Morphin and Rangers can actually track the consequences rippling out from minor shifts within the Meyer-Joyce field is incredible, and the level of informational detail they managed to obtain is amazing. But here's the thing, they've been at this for 2 years now, and they have not produced a single useful result. Yes, we can trace actual events from their small inception point to the actual consequences, very much in keeping with basic chaos theory concept of the butterfly flapping its wings, but, well, so what? Every single thing that happens in this universe is the result of such a chain of events. Being able to see the chain offers no real insight to anything due to the very randomness of the process. Furthermore, it's utterly misleading. You could say that more tiny evident or tiny decision in my life yesterday led me to writing this email, and that's technically true, but so did some tiny event or tiny decision in my life 15 years ago. It's all chain. The event yesterday didn't take place in a vacuum. It didn't come out of nowhere. So what's the point? We have no control over it. We don't get to direct it, and we get no useful information out of it. Also, have you actually seen the reports they generate from a technological standard point of view? The way they manage to automate their analysis of the fluctuation signatures within the Meyer-Joyce field is impressive, but again, it's all meaningless babble with no practical applications. Their personal remarks on the reports are even worse. With all due respect to Ron and Terry and their indisputable technical expertise, I don't know what they're doing, and I'm not sure they do either. It's like they're coming up with stuff at random. The above outlines my concerns as to the futility of the entire process, and I suspect that may be enough to sway you. But I have one final point, which I think you should consider very, very carefully. The entire program is an unforgivable waste of Monarch resources. I don't mean money, although the entire Quantum Ripple Casualty Research subdivision is costing us millions and millions of dollars. But that doesn't really matter, because I know we can afford that. However, there's a more vital resource they're consuming. Each time they fire up their rig and delve into the Meyer-Joyce field, they eat up a huge amount of Cronin particles. Those are a finite resource, and as you know, we are projecting that the ground zero yields that will rapidly diminish as the fracture takes hold, which will happen very soon. You may not understand what the real impact of this is, so let me put it to you in practical terms. Every single time they detect and analyze a quantum ripple, it costs a week of potential lifeboat running runtime minimum. Given Monarch's primary purpose and the total lack of useful results, I believe that is a luxury we cannot afford. I recommend shutting them down immediately or at the latest during our next rework. We can reallocate their resources to something useful and put Ron and Terry's expertise into great use designing the lifeboat. I'm sure we wouldn't regret putting them to work on that, given their track record of working with Cronin Tech. Yeah, screw it, I don't care. Some more emails.
Dr. Amaral was the one thing keeping Paul alive, but reading through their exchanges, there was something more than professional going on.
That's not my place to comment on.
I find myself at a loss. We knew that the fracture would arrive. It was clear very quickly that the process was occurring much faster than Paul's projections. His experiences had led us to believe. That was alarming in itself, but there's another concern with the fracture. Paul's condition seems to be accelerating rapidly. I don't know what to do about either one of these issues. I haven't had a chance to examine Paul properly, and of course he won't consent to any real tests at this point. He won't take the time, not with the situation being as critical as it is. He has to prepare for the gala, to take care of every little stupid thing Martin trots out for him. He won't think of himself at all, and I'm afraid that'll cost us dearly. So I don't know, I'm just speculating, but I believe this acceleration is a reaction to the stutters in time, in zero state. His wave function is further disrupted by the excessive Cronin energies within his body. Before the university incident, before the fracture, the condition was progressive but controllable. The lack of stutters helped keep it in check. Now its progress is rampant, and I worry that it may reach a critical point soon. We always knew that was a possibility, but all of our projections assumed we would have years, time enough to come up with a cure, or a way to stop its progress, which means that there's a very real chance that in the near future, Paul's condition overtakes him, and if he does become a shifter, I don't know what to do about it. We haven't been able to help Dr. Kim. I don't know what we could do for Paul. What we could do for Paul. I don't know what to do. The treatments are still working, but they take a toll on him, and their effect is greatly diminished. I'm concerned we may hit a point where he's forced to use them so often that the treatment becomes worse than the condition itself, and yet I don't see that any other options. He will not rest. He insists on doing so much. I know he chafes under his dependence on the treatments. He sees it as a weakness. I'm afraid I may lose him.
Paul was a powerful man, the leader of an empire, but behind the veil, he was a dying man. The signs were clear.
You're nuts.
Who the fuck are you?
Joss Wheeler. I'm tech support. No, seriously.
Joyce! Help!
Get down. Joyce, thank God. Shit, that could have been real bad.
Here, Charlie.
Yeah. Let me get this door open.
They'd stockpiled all the chronon particles from Ground Zero to keep the lifeboat running.
Enough to hopefully last until a proper solution was discovered.
Everyone, please be advised that we are now at a point where lifeboat activation may occur. Accordingly, I have ensured that preparations are underway for activation. As a part of that, what chronon particle stores still remain at the Ground Zero harvesting operation are being moved to the headquarters and placed into the master chronon particle respiratory, ready to be placed under the CFR's control. Please be aware that what we have managed to accumulate until this point is very likely to be all the chronon particles we ever have access to. Due to the fracture's effects on the Meyer-Joyce field, the Ground Zero anomaly is showing definite signs of weakening. As a result, the chronon particle yield decreases drastically and will soon drop to baseline. While we obviously continue more traditional chronon particle harvesting operations in order to maximize our stockpile, we all need to recognize that sourcing them outside of the Ground Zero conditions is extremely inefficient. Or, in plain terms, unless we find another source of chronon particles, and I don't believe we will, what we have now is all we will ever have. Please be aware that all use of chronon technology eats into our limited resources, and while we of course recognize that we need to have our strikers and other soldiers operate in stutters, each operation undertaken will eat away at our stockpile, and in very real terms cost us days of lifeboat runtime. Accordingly, we have to plan all use of this technology closely and choose our battles carefully. That said, we should also realize the ongoing situation with Jack Joyce constitutes an emergency and will most likely require unconventional chronon particle investment. Just the same, we should be aware of the cost. I expect to see projected chronon particle consumption rates for the foreseeable future and simulations of how long our stockpile will last, adjusted for all our scenarios we have discussed. See our last meeting minutes in our next Monday meeting.
There you go, Joyce. Here's hoping you know what the fuck you're doing.
Yeah, me too.
Well, there it is. CFR.
It took 11 years for Will to build the countermeasure. Beth died for it, and I knew it could fix the fracture. This fucking thing. Problem was, I didn't have a clue how to use it. The only person who did was dead. But Monarch had a way of getting to him before that ever happened. The University time machine. We've got the core here.
Can we go or what?
I need to get to the chamber above.
No problem. Got a way up right here.
Thanks for the help.
No biggie. Make it count.
Yeah. You're not coming?
No, I gotta get back down. Someone I really want to get back to. Good luck, Joyce.
Yeah.
Hey, why are you going up there anyways?
Short version? I gotta go back in time and save my brother.
You're gonna go back in time, yeah, right. Whatever. You don't have to tell me, I guess.
Paul took the core of the time machine from the university, hooked it up to his own machine. It was part of his sick desire for control, but that gave me one last shot at fixing things. I could go back, maybe get to Will before Paul killed him. And if I could get the countermeasure in Will's hands, maybe I could still turn everything around. Core was set, the machine was prepped. I had to put the corridor in place. Okay, this should do it.
God damn it, man.
I gotta stop doing that. When I turn red, I gotta start putting up my shield. Holy shit, I didn't realize how long this episode's been already.
Let's go.
I think I should have it beaten now. this is the last guy here. Yep.
Thanks for the heads up. Oh, you're welcome, you very slow machine lady.
The machine was ready. I just needed to put in the date. The earliest I could go back to was the time that the core was first activated. At the university.
Not much time to rescue your brother.
I didn't have a choice.
Alright, that's going to do it for this video, guys. Kindly like, subscribe, comment, Twitter, be announcers below. As always, guys, I'm a Crazy HD. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. See ya.